Hello friends, welcome to .NET programming tutorial. In this part we will learn what is the HTML in ASP.NET. So let's start with tutorial. If the page view state is completely disabled but still we want to maintain some information for current page, so we can use hidden field from toolbox. View state and hidden field both are used to maintain information for current page, not other page. It means that when redirection is occur, we cannot able to access the hidden field value, because we can maintain this information for current page only. Hidden field are not encrypted or protected. It can be changed by anyone. However, from security point of view, this is not suggested. ASP.NET use hidden field control for managing the view state. So don't store any important information or confidential data like password, credit card detail with this control. Let's see the advantage of hidden field. No server resources are required. The hidden field is stored and read from page. Widespread support. Almost all browsers and client devices support forms with hidden fields. Let's see the disadvantage of hidden field. Potential security risk. The hidden field can be tampered with. The information in hidden field can be seen if page output source is viewed directly. So to understand the use of hidden field, let's flip to Visual Studio. Now go to ASPX file. So here you can see that I have added one text box, and below text box I have added hidden field. And if we click on click button, so I want to assign some value to the text box. Each time I click on click button, I want to increment the value one by one. So let's go to Google Chrome. So I have already run this page. Now click on this button. You can see that initially the first time we click on this button, so zero value is assigned to the text box. Now again click on this button, then value is incremented by one. Now again click on this button. Here you can see that each time value is incremented by one. But how this is possible with hidden field? So to understand this, let's flip to Visual Studio. Go to CS file. When we first time we click on click button, so I am checking first if hidden field is having some value. It is empty, so assign zero value to the hidden field and then assign this hidden field value to the text box. So when we first time we click on the button, so zero value is assigned to the text box through the hidden field. Now when again we click on this button, so the we having some zero value, so this condition will not satisfy because we having zero value in hidden field. So it will go to the else statement, and we are incrementing the hidden field value by one, and we are assigning this hidden field value to the text box here. So each time we click on the button, so hidden field value is incremented by one. So this is how we can use the hidden field. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. To receive the notification, click on bell icon. Thank you.